Asterion Moloc, also known as the Bringer of Wrath and the Spear of Judgment, is the current reigning chapter master of the Minotaurs chapter of the Adeptus Astartes. Asterion is a warrior infamous for his brutality, paranoia, and malicious nature, and because of these traits, he is often described as being the very embodiment of the Minotaurs as a whole. While he is well known for his seemingly barbaric nature, Asterion is no mere brute, for the chapter master of the Minotaurs is also a highly disciplined master strategist with an aptitude for siege warfare. Upon the battlefield, Asterion is a veteran of thousands of battles, and as a warrior, he has few equals. Asterion will often lead from the front lines, battling alongside the elite warriors of his chapter's first company, taking great pleasure in the carnage that he and his warriors wreak upon the enemy. The Lord of the Minotaurs has cultivated an impressive reputation for himself, which is accentuated further by the fact that Asterion has personally slain many notable foes in combat, such as Orc warbosses, champions of the Dark Gods, and even renegade Space Marine chapter masters. Due to the Minotaurs often being dispatched by the High Lords of Terror for the purpose of persecuting traitorous or renegade Space Marine chapters, Asterion Moloc has developed an incredible proficiency in combating against such foes, viewing them as not only being the ultimate test of his chapter's skill in battle, but also as targets worthy of the Emperor's wrath. During the Badab War, the Minotaurs under Asterion's leadership would inflict so much devastation upon the renegade Lamentor's chapter that the Lamentors were ultimately forced to surrender. When not in battle, Asterion secludes himself within his throne room, which is situated within a vast labyrinth deep within his chapter's void-faring fortress monastery, the Daedalus Crater. Within the heart of this labyrinth, Asterion surrounds himself with countless data feeds and casualty reports that are compiled by numerous tabulation servitors, allowing him to monitor the various analytics relating to his chapter's goals at all times. In late M41, during the course of the Orphean War, the entire Minotaur's chapter would respond to the Orphean sector's call for aid against the Necrons of the Mainarch Dynasty. Asterion would personally lead a boarding action upon the Necron tomb ship designated by Imperial authorities as the Dead Hand, and would battle fiercely against the Necron overlord known as Kutlak, the war leader of the Mainarch Dynasty, before being grievously wounded and cast out into the void. The severity of Asterion's injuries was so severe that the Minotaurs initially deemed him lost before he was eventually recovered by Imperial forces. This is not the first time that Asterion Moloc has come so close to death, as the Lord of the Minotaurs was said to have perished at least 6 additional times over the course of the past 500 years. Seeing as there have been many seemingly erroneous reports regarding the death of Asterion Moloc, is he simply a warrior that is too stubborn to die, or could there be something more to his unexpected talent for survival? As detailed within Imperial Armor Volume 12, Asterion Moloc is shown to bear the telltale signs of numerous injuries, with much of his body being replaced and enhanced with a series of cybernetic augmentations. It would not be unreasonable to assume that Asterion is simply an incredibly resilient and durable warrior, even by the already impressive standards of the Adeptus Astartes, as there have been warriors from other chapters who have developed a notoriety for their stubbornness and the fact that they are seemingly impossible to kill, despite the sheer number and severity of wounds that they have incurred over the course of multiple battles. One such example of these supposedly unkillable Astartes is that of Captain Alessio Cortez of the Crimson Fists chapter. Cortez has become somewhat of a legendary figure within his chapter due to him sustaining wounds that should have slain him time and time again. As documented within the 3rd edition Space Marine Codex, such wounds that Cortez had suffered from include having a sword belonging to an Orc warlord lodged between his ribs during the Battle of Steel Cross, 17 separate wounds, two of them diagnosed as serious, including a punctured heart during his battle with an Eldari warhost, and conducting all 6 weeks of the Cardian campaign without supplies. All of these injuries suffered by the Crimson Fist were accrued over the span of just 5 decades. 30 years after the Cardian campaign, Cortez would suffer a number of additional injuries during the Battle for Rinsworld, including the loss of his right arm. Despite losing an arm, Cortez still reported for duty, and would only stand down after Chapter Master Pedro Cantor ordered for Cortez to wait for an apothecary so that his wounds could be tended to. As a result, it seems that the most likely explanation behind Asterion Moloch's resilience is that the Lord of the Minotaurs is nothing more remarkable than an Astartes who just so happens to display a stubbornness or natural toughness that is higher than average compared to that of a typical space marine. But what if Asterion is not an Astartes at all? Could he instead be a warrior drawn from the ranks of the Adeptus Custodes, the personal bodyguards of the Emperor of Mankind? The Custodes are themselves well known for not only their skill in battle, which surpasses that of even an Astartes, but also for displaying tremendous physical toughness and an unshakable resolve upon the field of battle, similar to that demonstrated by Asterion Moloc. One argument in favour of Asterion being originally from the ranks of the Custodes is tied directly to the Chapter Master's signature weapon, the Black Spear. The Black Spear is a weapon that is said to have once belonged to the Custodes, and is similar in both appearance and function to that of the Order's Guardian Spears, power weapons with an appearance reminiscent of a halberd with an integrated ranged weapon. While many Guardian Spears typically incorporate a bolt caster for ranged combat, the Black Spear does not. Instead, the Black Spear makes use of a single shot laser that is powerful enough to pierce the armor of a tank. This could potentially mean that the Black Spear is, in itself, a variant of the Guardian Spear known as an Adracite Spear, which incorporates a rare and powerful type of weapon known as an Adrathic Weapon. These Adrathic weapons can emit a powerful beam of energy that can sever the very internal bonds of matter, causing the target to disintegrate. The secrets behind the manufacture of Adrathic weapons are kept hidden from all but the Custodes, with not even the tech priests of the Adeptus Mechanicus being permitted the knowledge of their construction. However, it is also worth noting that other Space Marine chapters have been documented to have Guardian Spears within their armories. The Death Watch chapter is particularly noteworthy in this regard, as such weapons are often wielded by the chapter's Watchmasters. Another potential piece of evidence that could support the possibility of Asterion Moloc being a Custodian is that the Minotaurs are frequently used, for lack of a better term, as the attack dogs of the High Lords of Terror. The Captain General of the Adeptus Custodes is also capable of holding the position of High Lord, though not in any permanent capacity. Only 9 of the 12 High Lords hold a permanent position within the Senatorum Imperialis, with the remaining 3 seats being held by either the Lord Commander of Segmentum Solar, Lord Commander Militant of the Astra Militarum, Cardinal of the Holy Synod of Terra, Abbess of the Adeptus Sororitas, Chancellor of the Estate Imperium, Speaker of the Chartist Captains, Lord High Admiral of the Imperial Navy, or the Captain General of the Adeptus Custodes. Because of this, due to the rest of the High Lords holding little to no authority over the Custodes, as prior to the return of the Primarch Rabute Gilliman, they only answered to their Captain General and the Emperor himself, if the Chapter Master of the Minotaurs was indeed a Custodian, then the chapter would, presumably, have needed to be founded during a time when a Captain General held the position of High Lord. The current incarnation of the Minotaurs chapter was officially founded as part of the 21st Cursed Founding, which took place in late M35. While it isn't confirmed that the Captain General of the Adeptus Custodes held the position of High Lord at this time, It is strongly implied within the second edition Sisters of Battle Codex that Captain General Excelsor did hold the position of High Lord during the events of the Age of Apostasy, which occurred during early M36. As such, it wouldn't be unreasonable to assume that Excelsor was active as a High Lord during the later years of M35. It is theoretically possible that Asterion Moloc could have been a former custodian appointed by Captain General Excelsor to act as the chapter master of the newly founded Minotaurs chapter, although admittedly, there is little evidence to support this possibility. The final possibility regarding Asterion Moloch's multiple, supposedly erroneous accounts regarding his death is that the Lord of the Minotaurs did indeed die, and that his successor assumed his name and title upon their promotion to Chapter Master. This possibility is hinted at within Imperial Armor Volume 12, which even proposes that each successive individual who becomes the Chapter Master of the Minotaurs has their memories and personality physically altered to that of the previous incarnation of Asterion. However, this suggestion has been deemed by many as being little more than a slanderous accusation leveled against a chapter with an already unsavory reputation. But the idea of a Space Marine chapter having each successive chapter master adopt the name and title of their predecessor is not entirely unprecedented, as such an act has been known to take place within the ranks of the Silver Skulls chapter. As detailed within the novel Portents, the chapter master of the Silver Skulls holds the title of Lord Commander Argentius. The current incarnation of Argentius is speculated by Inquisitor Callus of the Order Hereticus to be Atreus, who was formerly the captain of the chapter's 6th company, and is said to be the 27th individual over the course of the chapter's history to have held the title. The idea that Asterion Moloc only survived his 7 deaths due to having his mantle taken up by another member of his chapter would indeed be a logical conclusion to come to, even if such an assumption would diminish his impressively fearsome reputation. Though, if this were the case, this would fail to explain as to why each incarnation of Asterion also appears to sport a large amount of cybernetic augmentation, unless the Minotaurs force each new chapter master to undergo such procedures in an attempt to maintain the legend of Asterion Moloc. Since the Minotaurs were stated to have a disproportionately high number of resources at their disposal, at least for a significant period of time, this idea is not beyond the realms of plausibility. Alternatively, the truth could be a combination of the previously mentioned hypotheses. For example, Asterion Moloc could potentially be a title held by multiple custodians that were personally appointed by the Captain General of the Adeptus Custodes. Or perhaps Asterion is nothing more than a mighty warrior who takes joy in waging war against the enemies of mankind, and simply refuses to die. We may never know for certain. What do you think? Leave a comment below, and thanks for watching!